As I stand here, hospitals across the country, across these islands, and across Europe are under siege from the disease, with already exhausted healthcare workers now facing a tsunami of infection even greater than the first wave. Already we have more COVID patients in our hospitals than ever before. In addition, we have an even more infectious strain of the virus in our midst. A study by London's Imperial College suggests that the new strain increases the R number by between 0.4 and 0.7, which can rapidly lead to growth well beyond previous worst-case scenarios. That is why we are doing this, and that is why we must dig deep within ourselves and face the coming month with steely determination and resolve. We simply have to suppress this surge and flatten the curve once again. The personal decisions that each and every one of us makes over the coming month will directly affect how many more people get sick and how many more people die. It is as stark and as simple as that. We are in a battle against a deadly and ever-changing virus. The lockdown we are introducing today is designed to reflect that stark and simple reality. Unless you are involved in absolutely essential work, you have no reason to be away from your home, and you simply must stay at home. So from today until at least the end of January, the following additional restrictions will apply, in addition to the full Level 5 protocol. All schools must remain closed, with teaching to move online. There will be two exemptions to this. Special education should remain open with protections in place, and Leaving Cert students should continue to attend school for 3 days a week from January the 11th. This has been a difficult decision. Education is the great equaliser and is the single most important factor in the great progress that this country has made since its foundation. The entire school and childcare community has undertaken heroic work over the last year, including the safe reopening of schools and childcare services, which took place in September. But while all of the scientific and public health evidence shows that schools and childcare services remain safe environments, the spread of the virus has got to the point where we must simply stop as much mobility within the country as we possibly can for at least the next 3 weeks. Education involves approximately 1 million people on the move on a daily basis. The two limited exemptions to disclosure are judged to be essential. Our Leaving Cert students deserve the chance to sit normal examinations this year, and as a government, we will do everything we can to make that happen. And while the closure of schools is a setback for all our children, it is particularly challenging for children and the families of children with special needs. While childcare services will close generally until the end of the month, they can remain open for vulnerable children and the children of essential workers. Again, a special tribute must be paid to the construction sector and the construction unions for the way in which they rose to the challenge of making sites COVID safe. However, the same considerations apply, and all construction with a number of exemptions must cease until at least the 31st of January. A full list of exemptions will be published on gov.ie. Government also took decisions today on additional business supports and restrictions on travel, which my colleagues will talk about shortly. As a people, we have responded well to the different phases of this pandemic. We have risen to all of the challenges that have presented themselves. We may now be entering the most challenging phase of all. Personal responsibility and behaviour are the key to getting through it. When even a small minority ignore the guidelines, the wider impact can be incredibly serious. We now have a vaccine, and it is being safely distributed as quickly as we receive it. We welcome the news today that the Moderna vaccine has now also been approved. But please believe me when I tell you that notwithstanding the vaccine rollout, truly enormous damage can be done if we let down our guard against the virus in any way in the time ahead. No one who watched or heard the story of Marita Tarago could fail to have been moved by it. Originally from the Philippines and living in Dalkey, Marita catered for sick patients at St. Vincent's Hospital. She contracted COVID and died on Christmas Eve after almost 20 years of caring for the people of Dublin. That is the risk faced by our families, our neighbours, and our friends on the front line of this pandemic. Each of us has a responsibility to do right by them. Each of us must remember Marita and the thousands of others who have been taken by the virus. Each of us must remember this sacrifice and find in our hearts the strength and the discipline to hunker down, to stay home, to follow the rules, and to get this virus under